Good morning, everyone. It's a great pleasure for me and Kumari to be here. This is a part of the world where we have the most fondest of memories. Me and Kumari studied at Maharajas many years back. We met there actually in 1974 and got married in 1979. So we had a wonderful time in this city in the 70s. Now coming to Rajagiri is also a special occasion for us. One of my teachers who taught me actually maths when I was in my pre-university, that was in 70-72, still teaches here, Ms. Shirley Poppen. It is always a privilege to meet your teachers and pay our respects. In many ways, I'm sure she not only taught me maths, she kept me out of trouble when I was 15 years old, actually kept me safe with her care and advice. So it's always a privilege to meet one of the old teachers and pay our respects. So thank you very much for inviting us. Order of business, congratulations. Congratulations to the Fourth Wave Foundation, specifically to Diana, to take up this journey over the last 3 years. We have not been that involved, but we have had a fairly good insight into this journey over the last 3 years by the foundation. Congratulations on launching Venda as well as SAFE. I think these are very important initiatives and it will make a difference over a period of time. I remember meeting Diana in an airport, if I'm right, some 3 years back. I'm sure she conveyed her passion and commitment and her vision in the 30 seconds she had in an airport. And I think that worked. So I introduced her to my wife, Kumari, told her that, you know, please take a look. And for my wife, for Kumari, I think it was more the maternal instinct rather than anything else. I'm sure all of you have heard about Infosys. My life has been extremely busy. I was hardly at home, which means she had the burden of bringing up both my children. And this must have been a constant worry in her mind about our children getting into a substance abuse situation, especially in a city like Bangalore. Also, all said and done, coming from a well-to-do family, it's even more a bigger risk because affordability is higher than most other children. So these children do get attracted much faster because they have the affordability. They live in a society where these kinds of experiments are kind of accepted. So I'm sure she was constantly worried about this while bringing up both our kids. And I think that is a switch which turned on immediately for her. And so I think it was an easy decision for us to be part of this endeavor. Now looking back, we were extremely lucky. Both our children have grown up and they are now both married. But we know many friends of ours who are going through struggle, who are going through a terrible time with their children, taking the wrong turn. Mostly it starts out as an experiment, as an experiment for the child and ends up in an addiction, which causes an enormous amount of pain and suffering for the family as well as everybody else involved. As I said, we have been extremely lucky in this matter. I always say this, in my lifetime we have progressed a lot. When I was studying in Maharajas, when I was studying, when she was studying in St. Teresa's, this was a very different country. Opportunities were very less. In fact, the biggest struggle at that time was to find a job. Today, most children, at least the children who do very well in school or in college, the biggest struggle is to choose the job. Not to find one, but to choose which one it is. So we have come a long way in the last 30 years. So there has been an enormous amount of progress. The number of middle class has increased tenfold. We graduate almost a million engineers every year. And as I said, today's children have a lot more opportunities than what we had when we were growing up. But at the same time, life has become much more tougher for our children. Today's children go through enormous amount of pressure, not the kind of pressure which me and Kumari went through, I'm sure. They go through enormous amount of pressure to perform, to compete, to find a job, to choose a job. In all aspects, the pressures on our children today are much more than what it was in the past. And also, parents have become extremely busy. Most families have parents who are working, both parents working, and the joint family system has almost disappeared. And it will continue to disappear with the kind of mobility our people have today. So these situations do put our children at greater risk. And as I said, most of them start out as a curiosity, as an experiment, and ends up in an addiction. Now, the scene in Kerala is a bit more alarming than probably other states and other cities. And it is important that we take early steps to contain this epidemic from destroying our most precious asset. Those are our children. As with any other issue which we have in this country, a scale is always a problem. The scale is much larger than most other parts of the world because the numbers are higher. And it requires, and taking this journey is a very complex task, very complex process. And it requires not one group, not one NGO, not one government, not one academic institution. It requires participation from all the stakeholders, which is the NGO, the academic institution, government, society, parents, every other entity which can get involved. You need participation from all of these entities. And I see SAFE as an event which will bring all the stakeholders together and all the decision makers together. I think it's a major, very important step to take towards intervening or attacking this epidemic. I believe this will be an yearly event which will chart out a path to keep our schools safe, our kids safe. I wish all of you all the best. I have met Diana, as I said, many times and her team occasionally. I think there are three things which you need if you want to do unreasonable things. One is courage. You need the courage because doing unreasonable things are always difficult. And only unreasonable people take this journey. So you need courage, commitment and capacity. And I really believe Diana and her team have all these three on their side. They have the courage to take up this journey. They're committed and I believe they have the capacity to make a difference. So once again, I wish you all the best and thank you very much for inviting us here. I also want to take a minute and thank everyone else who is here. I think your presence will be the courage for this team to continue this journey. Thank you, all the best.